The recent National Household Survey found that nearly 80% of Ugandans diagnosed with non-communicable diseases were unaware of their own status due to the lack of diagnostic facilities. According to the World Health Organization, non-communicable diseases kill 41 million people each year, equivalent to 71% of all deaths globally. These mortality rates are attributed to dietary risk factors. It's why the Uganda Parliamentary Alliance on Food and Nutrition Security, in partnership with the Center for Food and Adequate Living Rights, CEFROT, have launched a Parliamentary Nutrition Week to promote healthy diets through legal empowerment and awareness.
We are looking at promoting physical activity, doing exercises that will help minimize NCDs and any other illnesses that could arise. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are calling upon each and every one of us to embrace, to join this cause, to join this campaign. It will be a 4 days campaign where we will have a lot of activity starting today, tomorrow, Wednesday, and Thursday.
The number of diseases that are rampant today, the non-communicable diseases, cancers, high blood pressure, diabetes, are just mainly because of what we eat. So it starts with meat, starts with you, all of us, to be responsible in the way we eat.
MPs raised concerns that majority of laws responsible for regulating food safety are too old to address current challenges of trans fatty acidic foods, which are causing most non-communicable diseases. Laws like the Foods and Drugs Act, Public Health Act, among others, were enacted in the colonial days, and legislators want them amended urgently.
And for me, as a person, I think this policy is outdated, is outfashioned, and cannot fit with the current situation in which we are living in Uganda. This UNBS also is in 1965, and it's also outfashioned because there are many years that have elapsed. So
how can we have food storage improved to avoid this? But I want to agree with you that we have a lot of aflatoxins because of the way we handle our soil, the way we handle our storage, and the way we handle the food that has already been prepared for us to eat.
Food safety experts from the World Health Organization and CEFROT sensitized members of parliament on the legal and regulatory measures needed for promoting healthy diets and physical activity. They underscored the urgent need for legislation to make nutrition labeling mandatory and also restrict marketing of fat, sugar and salt to children.
As of parliament, we need this to be regulated so that they put a clear interpretative telling that when I look at this packet, even from a 5, even if I don't know how to read, if it's color-coded, it will be easy to see. They put against sugar green, against salt green, against so much. So you just look at the color and say, this is the product that I want to buy because it is healthy for me. And you easily see it when you look at the shelf. It's not at the back. You know, it hits you in the face so you can see it. That's why we want the parliament to have regulations on labeling so that we know what we are buying.
The parliament declare maybe a month in Uganda, and it is dedicated to nutrition, like it is done in other countries, where we say maybe the month of March in Uganda is a nutrition awareness month. In the districts, everywhere, in the hospitals, in schools, we are singing nutrition because many people are dying, many people are sick, many children can't study well because of nutrition.
Many of the staple foods that we consume should be fortified because of the high burden of malnutrition that we have. We have a big percentage of our mothers, children, who are actually anemic and they have also other micronutrient deficiencies. We would like to ensure that some of the staple foods are fortified with the required nutrients so that we contribute to reduction of malnutrition in this country.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.